Hi, friends, and welcome to Game Day Eve from GoJacks.com. We're inside the Sanford Jackrabbit Athletic Complex, where the SDSU offense has been practicing with noise throughout the week to get ready for the big matchup coming up tomorrow in the Fargo Dome. Top-ranked North Dakota State hosting third-ranked South Dakota State. And if you haven't drowned in all of the hype, well, then let's get a little more added on to it, shall we? The Jackrabbits and the Bison meeting for the 15th time for the Dakota Marker. NDSU has won 8, SDSU 6, including the previous two matchups for the Rock. The Jacks won the meeting in Brookings a year ago, 33-21. The big stories in that game, NDSU committed 5 turnovers. Taryn Christian threw for 320-plus yards and a couple of touchdowns. Jacks possessed the ball for 35 minutes in that game. And you look at the history of this series, time of possession and running the football have been two huge numbers, and no doubt they will be when the Jacks and Bison meet up tomorrow in the Fargo Dome. SDSU is number 3 in the nation, 2-0. North Dakota State, let's talk about the Bison. 3-0, 3 home FCS wins, all in dominant fashion. Easton Stick, the quarterback, a 3-time team captain. He and Christian are probably the two best quarterbacks in the nation. Stick is something special. 63 touchdowns to 21 interceptions. He came off the bench for an injured Carson Wentz his freshman year and led the Bison all the way to the national championship game. Then he's been the starter and again team captain the last 2 years, and then again here as a senior. Joined by Bruce Anderson in the backfield. Anderson averaging better than 8 yards a carry, top 10 nationally in rushing average. There's not just Anderson, though. There's Dunn, there's Brooks. The Bison are very talented at running back, and it starts up front with an excellent offensive line. You shift to the defensive side of the ball. The starting defense for North Dakota State has only allowed 1 scoring possession all year, a Cal Poly field goal in the opener. All the other points scored on North Dakota State in the first 3 games, either against the backup defensive units or on a return in which the NDSU offense began the play with the football. When we talk about North Dakota State defensively, they get to the quarterback. 12 sacks. Greg Menard, who missed all of last year with an injury, is back. The Lakeville, Minnesota native is something special. Jabril Cox, one of the best linebackers in the nation. NDSU has forced 7 turnovers in 3 games. They come in 2nd in the nation in total defense, allowing fewer than 190 yards per game. So it's the typical North Dakota State defense the Jacks will see tomorrow afternoon. And NDSU has a tremendous home field advantage. 45-3 North Dakota State is over the last 6 years. 30 of those 45 wins in the Fargo Dome have been by 20 or more points. And there's only 2 active quarterbacks in the FCS who have won as a starting quarterback in the Fargo Dome. One, of course, is Easton Stick of North Dakota State. The other is Taryn Christian. And the Jacks will try to pull off a similar feat to what they did 2 years ago with that 19-17 win in the Fargo Dome on the Christian to Winicky touchdown pass with just a second remaining. Again, turnovers, time of possession, likely to be huge stats in this one, and the hymn will be sung on the interior. Line play will be so crucial. Both these teams on offense and defense winning the battle of the trenches. Typically, whoever has won that battle, won the time of possession, won the rushing game, that has been who has won when the Jackson Bison have gotten together. Kickoff will be at 2:30 tomorrow afternoon inside the Fargo Dome. We'll have radio coverage throughout the Jackrabbit Sports Network at 1:30 on Saturday afternoon. You can also watch the game. Our friends Tom, Hank, and Elena from Midco Sports Network will be up there as well to bring the telecast to you throughout the region. Should be a tremendous amount of fun. Number 1, North Dakota State. Number 3, South Dakota State. If you can't get excited for this one, well, I don't know what to do about it, folks. You just sit back and enjoy. Should be a ton of fun in Fargo tomorrow afternoon. 2:30 the kick, the Jacks and the Bison, the 15th playing for the Dakota Marker.